Hello, I'm Becky Campbell, here to help you make the most of your quilting time. Please like and subscribe so you know when I add more time-saving tips and techniques.
This is going to be a binding preview to make sure that our seams in the binding do not end up in the corners.
On this corner, you can see this seam is going to end up there. That would be a lot of bulk when we have to fold it back to change directions. We're going to go back to the top and make an adjustment. We have this seam that is past the corner, but because the other corner is on the corner, we're gonna just pull this down that amount, see if we can get the other corner to clear. I'm going to pin it here so that it doesn't slide around when I'm moving it below. So this adjustment that we just made, you can see that the seam got moved down there, so it's not going to create bulk in the corner. So that's corner number two. Let's see if we can get 3 and 4 to work out for us. I got lucky and 3 and 4 didn't have any seams that landed in the corner. So I'm going to try and pay attention so that these get lined up so that when it's sewn on the diagonal, it'll be a really nice match. I'm going to pin the corners and leave those in place, and then we'll move it to the ironing board so you can see the way that I attach the binding before it gets sewn on. When the binding comes together, here's a seam. I am going to create my other seam further down here so that we don't have two so close together. And I'll have to pay attention to make sure that I'm matching up the stripes. Really cannot square this quilt up. It has to just be as square as it is because I would be cutting points off. Really don't want to do that. The other thing to point out, when I trim my quilts down first time off of the quilting machine, I leave a good amount of area on the outside because I think that it's so much easier than trimming it exactly where you want it, and then it feels like you're sewing off of a cliff. If you have this much laying out there, you've got the back that will stay down nicely and not get folded up in there. So I always leave that and then trim it after I put the binding on. This is what my ironing board looks like, and it sits on top of a bookcase. I just had what I think is a really good idea. So I figure the less I have to manipulate the quilt and scrunch it up, I can just lay my ironing board on the floor, put the binding on that way, which I do with the Elmer school glue instead of pins. So this is my plan as to how to line up this binding so that it doesn't cut off the star point. I've put this little quarter inch ruler down where the star points go, and the edge of that fabric is a quarter inch. So that's what we're going to use to align the binding. One thing I think I should point out, I'm putting the binding on the front and sewing it on with a quarter inch seam allowance, and then I'll be turning it to the back once I trim down the excess. This is the raw edge right here that goes to the outside, and then this will be the one that turns over. I've already put Elmer school glue inside of here when I ironed this double so that I don't get any shifting. I want to show you how I apply the glue so you know where it's going. So I bend this binding back, and I want to just run a little bit of glue right along the top, which is the raw edge, the cut edge that's going to go to the outside of the quilt. You don't need a lot. I want to steam it in place. You can see I can put my finger in there and lift it up, and the glue is holding it. Holds it really nicely, and there's no pin distortion. Let's look and see how we turn the corner. And we're going to go back here, apply a little bit of glue, lay this down, steam it in place. The steam is what really sets the glue. This is the other edge. What we want to do is take this and we're gonna fold it back. So cut edge, this is the finished edge, and this is the straight line that we're going for. So we're gonna fold this back, and I'm gonna use my stripe to line it up well and steam that. So we're steaming that. And remember I said I wanted to line up these stripes, so I come up with a nice diagonal. So we folded it back this way. Now we come back this way. If I lift this up, you can see that my stripes are gonna line up. Okay, steam those. Continue along, applying some glue. And you want to be using the glue in a bottle that has a little tip, because if you use this straight out of the Elmer's school glue, it's just gonna apply way too much glue and then you would have a mess. Steaming it in place. And I'm gonna work around the other side, and then I'll come back and show you how I make the connection. But I really like laying this out here on the floor with the ironing board on the floor. I'm like so excited that I had that idea today. We wanna review that
This is a seam here, and then we're going to make a connection, join the binding, and this is another seam here. So I'm looking to do the seam right here in this area. Because we're going to be connecting these two pieces together, we need to have them not glued down so that we have some leadway. And if you remember, I said that I had glued these and the glue starts right there, and I'm going to need to break that glue simply by doing that, take it back. The same with this tail. I didn't put it all the way to the end because I knew, and there's that. This is right about where I want my seam to be, so I need to pull it back. All right, let's look at this binding. So the binding comes this way, and then we're going to fold it so that we have this angle here. It lays down smooth, and we're going to apply a little bit of glue on that angle. We're going to take this binding, going to lift this up, tuck this up in there so it fits nice and snug. Then we're going to fold this down, and we're going to match those stripes, and it's laying nice and smooth. Hit it with the iron, and it's going to set the glue, and then we'll be opening it back up. I'll give you a better view of that to sew this, but we've got to pull the quilt up to do that. All right, I'm going to show you. I've folded the quilt up so that I'm not dragging so much weight, and I don't want to start at the corners because that gives you too much pull. So I'm going to start somewhere a third of the way down, or stitch a quarter inch around to attach the binding. By having this extra here, it keeps backing fabric from getting pulled out underneath because there's plenty of it to lay flat. The other thing to mention, because there are no pins, there is no distortion, and the glue just holds the binding in place, and I can just stitch. We're coming to the corner, so I've turned the quilt, and then I'm gonna just stitch off this edge. So here's a close-up view of what that looks like. So I'm back at the corner, and I've stitched off that edge, and I'm gonna fold this back, and then I'm gonna stitch down this side. A tip is that you want to rearrange the quilt. See how it's all folded up? The area that you're sewing on to be laying flat, you don't want the weight of the quilt to drag it down or out the position that you want it in. Kind of have to wrestle with a bear. The next step is to sew this seam on the binding. Pick this quilt up so we can get some space in here. I am going to pin this or use clips, but we're going to put those in there to hold the quilt together so we have plenty of room to make this seam. We're going to move our quilt out of the way. We're going to find this diagonal line, and you can see I've already sewn it, but what we had done was open it up, sew on the diagonal line, pull it up, and we pop this seam open because there was glue there and we want it to lay flat. So we pop it open. So then I'm going to trim the tails of the binding, making sure I just got the tails, with a quarter inch ruler. We're going to trim that off and then press it open. Then we're going to have the perfect fitting binding, and we'll sew the binding on to finish this up. I'm at the ironing board, and I just trimmed it with a pair of scissors and guesstimated. And then I'm just going to take the iron and press it open, press the fold back into it. We're ready to sew the rest of it on. So this is where I stopped sewing before I created the connection. I'm going to just set my needle down at my quarter inch, and I've flattened the part out I'm sewing so I have a straight shot of it. And I didn't glue this down. There's only one place for it to go, and it's kind of just staying right in position. It could be glued if you wanted. We're just going to go for, hopefully I won't regret not gluing it down. When I'm sewing, I'm trying to pull the weight so that it's not pulling on where I'm sewing. Let's see what the diamonds look like. Yes, they look really good. So we're gonna just keep on going. I'm gonna peek under here and see where I'm positioned, just to make sure I'm not pulling it too far down. Looks good. Adjust some more so that the area I'm sewing on stays nice and flat. I'm coming up to the other side where it's sewn. Where my finger is, that's the other end that was sewn down. So what you can see here is this, it's laying totally flat when I come up to the other side that was sewn down. And we'll just look, that makes me really happy, where it comes right to that point. Now, all of them won't be perfect, but we're going to be close enough that it's going to work really well.
The next step that we're going to do is we're going to trim down the excess backing. We want to make sure right here, this is folded over. When we trim that, we want to make sure that we're nowhere near that. So sometimes it's a good idea just to bend it back. I like to just take my mat off of the table and put it down on the floor so that it's just a lot less struggle if the quilt is laying flat. When this binding folds over, we want to make sure there is fill in there so that it isn't really flat. That means a little bit less than a quarter of an inch, and we'll trim this down and fold it back just to test it. We're going to fold this over and then fold it to the back, the right amount in the front. And when we fold it to the back, same right amount. Let's go back. And I have the quarter mark right on the edge of the binding, and I'm really happy with how that fills up the binding. I'm going to go around and trim it. I just slide my mat along the floor, trim it all out. I've completed trimming this out, and I just wanted to make a couple comments. When I put my mat on the floor, it works well for me because my carpet is pretty flat. Sometimes the mat is a little squishy when you're going around. It's not as solid as a table, but I can work with it. But if your carpet is real fluffy, then you might want to put a stabilizer like a board or something underneath your mat so that it doesn't throw your straight cut off. This step is got the binding turned to the back. I'm going to go along here and run my fingernails along here to make sure that if there was any glue that was back there, that it pops it loose. The only color that doesn't like the glue is black. If I need to dab off some of the glue, I can just take a wet washcloth and run it along here, and it will just remove the glue. Again, I'm using the Elmer's glue, but in a small bottle. So what we're going to do, come along here, make sure this is all free. We pull it back. I put my ironing board back down on the floor. One precaution is you have to make sure that you do not put your iron on your carpet. All right, we're going to turn the binding to the back. I've ironed it flat on the front and turned the quilt over to the back. Let's look at this little corner. The corner, you have a lot of material. So when it comes to corners, I really carefully go along here, trim off that excess, because this will get filled up with everything else that's in there, and it just makes it easier to fold down. This stitching line right here is my stitching line for when I put the binding on the front. So that's the line that I want to fold the binding back to and cover up, and then I know that I have an even binding on the front and on the back. So we're back to Elmer's glue. It stabilizes everything, it washes out, and I don't have to have any pins. I intend to sew the binding back by hand because I don't want to have a stitch that runs through these stripes. When I finish up with this one, I'll show you another quilt that I did where it didn't matter, so I sewed with the machine. So I'm going to take, and this is going to fold up and cover that stitching line. And then I know I've got the same amount on the front and the same amount on the back. I'm going to use my Elmer's school glue in the little bottle. I'm going to put it along here. I'm not going to start at the corner because the corner is too hard to wrestle with right off the bat. I want to start down further and I can come back and work the corner in. I want to cover that stitch line, make sure the material underneath is laying nice and flat and that I'm not distorting my stripe. So I can come in here and kind of hold it down. The glue will hold it a little bit. I'm going to need to steam it with the iron because that sets the glue. Kind of working backwards, but let me get this in here and I can show you. Okay, so let's steam that. I think I usually go this way. So find what is most comfortable for you to do, but you kind of can't see what I'm doing when I'm going that way. So I'm going to go along and steam. This is where the glue is. I gave it a second just to cool down. I'm running my finger along there, pulling it back, and it's holding. There have been quilts that I have made and attached the binding, turned the binding back like this, and actually traveled for years before I actually hand-stitched them down. Let's look at the corner. So I want to turn this corner so that you can see how I do it. So apply a little bit of glue there and make sure that you're covering that stitch line. Set that in there. So go one side, and then we're going to come over, do this one. Oh, that worked out pretty good. This is already folded down for you. Sometimes you'll have to adjust it a little bit. Let me put a little bit of glue in here. Fold it over. So what you want to happen is that these two corners meet together like that. Iron in place and try not to burn your fingers. And then you have a nice corner that matches up perfectly. I have ironed the binding in place, and you can see if I run my hand along along here, it's well attached, so I will be able to hand stitch that down without any pins or clips, and it will hold very well. Then I'm going to show you this other binding, which I did the other day. On this quilt, I really wanted the black binding on top, but because the back was pink, I didn't really want to have black because it just didn't seem to coordinate at all. So I went on the internet and looked up two-tone binding and found a great tutorial. This turned out excitingly well. This one I stitched by machine because I was concerned that my hand stitching might not hold it in place and I didn't want it to shift and roll. I applied this binding the same way I showed you doing the other binding with the glue, so everything stays in place. And when I'm stitching in the ditch along here, this is laying down and not shifting at all. One note that I would like to mention, when I trimmed this quilt, I didn't trim it quite enough. So as when I was folding over the binding, I was folding part of the quilt over. I went back and trimmed a little bit more. I flipped it over, made sure my binding was out of the way, and used my ruler to trim off just a little bit more. So when I folded it, I wasn't scrunching up the underneath. There you have it. Now I need to get to stitching the binding down by hand. Thank you.